There's no way that doesn't imprint deeply on you for the rest of your life. No way. Dances was most certainly a story of the loss of the West. One of the great lines in the movie, when the captain says to him, you know, why are you going out there?
Do you want to see the frontier? Yes, sir. Before it's gone.
So right there was, you know, the whole key to the, what the movie was going to be about.
Hold it! Hold it!
You know, things that work in films are very black and white. They either work or they don't work. They don't kind of work. And that dun, da, da, dun, 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 you know, you just went, like, that works.
I'd been very ill. I'd been ill for 2 years. So Dances was the first thing I wrote after I'd been out of action for 2 years. Music is a very personal thing. Music, I mean, probably the most personal thing of anything. And you can create, whereas literature gets very specific about the details, so you're following the specifics of the writer. Music doesn't have those specifics, but it carries the mood.
One of the only crafts that a director really doesn't know how to do. You know, you put your whole self in the hands of a composer. It's like you actually give this thing to him and you say, can you make this better?
When I sit down and write, I can start at maybe 7 in the morning, and then I'll look at my watch at 11:30. I mean, I'm like exhausted, as if I physically went through something, you know. So it's the doing of something with passion.
When John is working on a project, he has unbelievable tunnel vision. Nothing else is existing, and the rest of the universe shuts down, basically, and he goes into his rooms and he doesn't really come out until he's through, and one has to be respectful that that's where he's working.
The worst thing you can do is fall in love with the first idea you get. You just go until you think you've come to the end of a thing and I've totally nailed this. You never know what's going to trigger off something. But I do have total faith in the fact that something will arise out of the dark that's going to perk you up. And you never know when that's going to happen. You know when it happens. When it happens, you know, oh, God, yeah, it's like a gun going off. It's like, got it. I'm doing my albums now, and I did The Beyondness of Things. I'm doing another album at the moment based on John O'Donohue's book Eternal Echoes. It's very much inspired by John's writings. There's a certain spirituality about it, but there's a lightness to it, and there's a kind of Irish whimsy to it, which is nice. I never thought you would be able to have that much fun with the priest.
It amazes me, actually, that somebody who's moved in that whole superstar world, that he has held his substance so completely, because he's in a real conversation with himself. And it's that integrity that I love.
How adjacent.
From reading the book, there was an instinct that I loved the way the man wrote.
For instance, they believe that in November, mean a sauna, the month of the dead, that the veil was actually pulled back. So in a place like this, they almost claim that it's...
There is a huge longing for some kind of rootedness. And that's what the Eternal Echoes book about is about, our yearning to belong.
I find my own mental movie, my own sense of drama, whatever that might be. It is a film score. I just don't have any film. The family name is Prendergast. They were all over the place, basically Cork. There must be something in one's background, one's spirit, that just connects in a strange way. It's a wonderful feeling.
John Patrick's arrival definitely has been a rebirth for John in the most positive way, and it has energized him. I don't think that John would have been able to write The Beyondness of Things or Eternal Echoes at another time in his life. For a variety of reasons, I think, you know, he now has the security to write for himself, whatever he wants, however he wants.
He is writing music that is virtually symphonic. At the same time, he's not losing the audience. Most of the great film writers of today are, in fact, writing virtually the only classical music that people hear now, because the average classical composer is writing music that isn't warm enough for people to understand or to hear very much.
I do think style is important. It's certainly identifiable as his music. I like to hear a score where, if it's possible to identify who's written it, he's a composer.
I started, I mean, 1 year, I did 8 moves in 1 year. I don't know how the hell I did it. But if now I can get just one really terrific movie a year, I'll be very happy.
That's a cigarette butt. We don't need that.
No.